Oh shit, here we go again.
Okay, so your autofill support. You're one win away from promos, and your team won't let your main roll. Don't worry, I'll do my best to get you through this as best as I can. Quickly, time is not on our side. I'll present three easy gems which should do fine as first time. Pick one depending on what you need, and I'll explain what to do with them in the loading scene. If your team has a decent frontline, pick Soraka. She's a very forgiving pick and has the potential to heal your ADC through lane phase. And after that, she will provide very nasty utility with her E. Pick Nautilus if your team lacks CC, peel, or tankiness. Or if you want a decent counter to enchanters such as Soraka, Nami, or Janna. Pick Brand if your team lacks damage, or if you have a full AD con. Okay, now we have the champions out of the way. Skip to this timestamp in the video and I'll briefly go over what your champ does and how to play it. Soraka's purpose is to keep your team alive and make their mistakes more forgiving. Soraka's Q is a skill shot that damages enemies and heals you when you hit an enemy champion. Take this level 1 and max it after W. W is what will give your ADC a free lane. You damage yourself and heal an ally. Heals more when you hit Q. Max this ability and sustain your ADC up to max. E is your only peel ability and it has potential to completely turn around the teamfight. It's a silencing area that will turn into a root at the end of its duration. Your ultimate is a global heal which you should use to turn around close fights all across the map. For first item I prefer starting with Ancient Coin. After that I will usually go Redemption into another peel item such as Knight's Vow or Locket of the Iron Solari. Whether I need the CDR or the instant shield to keep my team alive, I usually take Locket of the Iron Solari when the enemy team has a lot of assassins. For boots, I usually get tanky boots such as Ninja Tabi or Mercury Threads, depending on whether they have a lot of CC or a lot of AD. To complete my build, I usually go something with tank stats in case the enemy team dives the backline. The way you're supposed to play Soraka is just stand back and heal your team as much as you can. Try to protect mostly your ADC, but if you're in a good position, heal your tanks and bruisers as well. Always stand in the back. Use your E to peel off assassins. Try to keep your team alive as best as you can. Now good luck, go heal them. Nautilus is a tank that can swap between two main roles. Either you go peel tank or engage tank. You'll have to make the crucial decision between which one of the two you pick. Sometimes it's better to stay in your carry and CC everyone that touches him. This strategy is usually best when you know your ADC's output is way higher than the enemy's output, and that he has the potential to solo carry a teamfight when he's not getting focused. The second strategy, however, is usually better for solo queue. It's basically the opposite. You dive in with whoever can follow you and CC their carries. This strategy usually works best when you have a team that can follow up. In lane phase, you're gonna wanna play passive until you get a good opportunity to hit Q, which is a skill shot that once hit an enemy champion, drags you towards him, making you meet in a midway point, CCing them in the process. After that, you follow up with an auto attack, causing your passive to proc, which makes them rooted for half a second and is usually enough for in the early game for your ADC to get some nice damage off. If the enemy is squishy, instantly ignite him. After that, you follow up with an E, if you have it, and a W to auto attack reset. But this one isn't completely necessary. You might sometimes want to use it for only the shield instead. Once you got your ultimate, use it on the furthest away target. Your ult is a heat-seeking missile, which knocks up everyone who it touches until it reaches the enemy champion you targeted. Sometimes it's better to use it on the furthest away target to CC as many people as you want, but if you want to make sure a critical target dies, use it on them instead. You start Q and max it if you want more opportunities to hook, and E if you want a better chance to one hook, one kill the enemy. This is the build with power spikes marked. Now go hook 'em. For runes, take either Dark Harvest if you want to go cheese, or Commit if you want to stand back and poke more. Rend is one of the highest damage supports in the game. He has the damage to carry entire team fights. You start the game with W, which is the area that damages targets. This is your bread and butter for damage, so you start it and max it every game. If you're new to this champion, use this ability in base so you get a quick feel for it. After W, you take Q. This is a skill shot that stuns if the target is marked by one of your other abilities, which is your passive. Your passive causes enemies that have gotten hit by one of your spells to burn, and after a third ability, ticking time bomb on them, which will explode for a huge amount of damage. Your E is a point and click ability, which is usually best to prepare your Q for. Your ult is a point and click ability that bounces between enemies for an easy couple of passive procs. In lane phase, you're gonna wanna look to poke with W, and all in somebody when you see good opportunity for stun. Usually in the early game, when you manage to proc your passive and you ignite them, you're gonna force at least two summoners, or you get a kill, or in best case scenario, you'll get both. In teamfights, look to ult people when they're together, and then follow up with the rest of your damage. Sometimes it's best to save your Q for peel, but a lot of times it's better for engage. You're gonna wanna start Spell Thief. After that, upgrade it once. and no more. For boots, you're gonna wanna get your sorcery shoes as soon as possible. After that, get yourself a Liandry. Once you've got your Liandry, you'll have an insane amount of damage. After that, you can go for one of these items, specifically Rylai's if you want to slow them, providing some extra utility, Void Staff if they have a lot of MR, or Morello's if they've got a lot of healing. Usually it's best to take a Zhonya's afterwards. You can also sometimes get the Ludens if your team needs the wave clear, and the Death Cap if you're insanely fed, or you're at 40 minutes in the game and you already sold your boots. Now go burn them. Consider sending this video to your autofill support. Also, consider subscribing for more dumb League of Legends content. Thank you. Have a great day.